in C#, we can create our own variables here. In some languages like Python, you don't really have to specify what the variable is. It just makes it easier. But in my opinion, it's odd because you don't know what's inside that variable, right? So we could do something like int. We'll just call it number for now and set it equal to 0. And then you have to put the semicolon at the end because that is C# syntax. And that allows the compiler to know when the end of that line of code is. Because that's one command, right? This command is creating a integer and we named it number and we set it equal to 0. Now we have to specify, right? But there are different forms of numbers. So integers are just numbers, like strictly numbers, no floating point values after it. And of course there's a max, but there's ways around that, of course. So for floating point values, we have floats and we call it my float. So with this, we can have, like 10.5. And that doesn't give us an issue. But if we were to do something like 0.0f here, that should give us a compiler error. And it does because you cannot make a integer a float after specifying. Of course, if you are doing different math operations, you can always cast. And what casting does is it changes what it is as a like variable, so you can cast certain things, but that's not really how we do it anymore. We usually do a lot of try parsing just to make sure things work. And so you can cast, but there's like drawbacks to it here and there. So that is a thing. Now with this, we have our numbers taken care of because you have like doubles or longs and things like that. But we are not really going to get into those. We're not using them today. And they're special use cases, I guess. Like they're just larger numbers, like larger containers to hold numbers. So we don't really want to get into that. So we also have strings, right? And what a string is it's a word or sentence. So if it's a word, we could just do word, comma, but we can add as many as we want. Okay? So we can add as many of these as we want, but we forgot to name it. So we name it my string, set it equal to this, and now we need a semicolon at the end because that is proper C# syntax. So we can save that there. And in doing so, we now have a number, a float, and a string. Now, if we only needed, say, one letter, we could put it in a char, my char, and set it equal to H, right? And now if we do this, it's perfect. But if you add anything more than just one letter, it gives us an issue. Now it just char represents character because it's singular and we can't have more than one. So that is what that is in terms of. So let me just move this stuff a little bit cleaner. Awesome. So that's what that is. So those are like basic variable types in C#. They can be used a lot of different ways. Sweet. So follow along and I'll explain things as we do them. And then if you have any questions, make sure just to type it in chat or unmute your mic and stop me and I'll explain it, okay? So we're going to start off by learning just the basics and we're going to do a console, which is capital C, and then spell out the rest of console dot write line. And then parentheses, then your quotation marks, and then just type hello world. Oops. Excellent. Oh, there we go. So now if we run this, for you, it might not close, but for me, you'll see what happens. It does this, right? So it ran, but it didn't run too fast. Like it ran so fast that we didn't get to see it, so it didn't run properly, right? So we're just going to do a few enters, and we're going to do a console.readline, right? And all this is doing is waiting on us to press enter. And now if we click start, we will see hello world. We click enter and our program closes, right? So that's exactly how we want it set up.
Be sure to join TechDev Academy's workshops and camps and also read some great articles on their blog page.